morning, children. In the previous class, we have learned about the test for starch, proteins, and fats. So, children, in this class, now we will learn the testing of food items for carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. That means which food item contains which type of component. Now we will see. All the food items contains major all the essential components, but whereas in some quantities these are in minute, so we should negligible, we should not count it into account. So now here in this table we have written some columns. Now let us see. Serial number, food, starch. What is the other name for starch, children? Carbohydrates. The other name of starch is carbohydrate. This P is the letter we have to represent for present. If the food item contains starch in it, then we have to write present. A for absent. Absent. So if the food item does not contain starch in it, then you have to write absent, children. So next column, proteins, and next column, fats. Children, do you remember these proteins are very very important in bodybuilding? So next, coming to the fats, these fats are also most energy giving food in our diet. Starch, the other name of starch is carbohydrate. So now we have to check for that food item contains starch or proteins or fats or all together. Now we will see. Now here in the table, first one is rice. What is the first one? Rice. So rice is rich in carbohydrates or starch. Daily we are eating vegetables along with rice, children. So we are taking more amount of rice in our food. So that's why this rice definitely should contain more amount of starch or carbohydrate. So here in this column I have written present. Why? Because rice contains starch in this one. Next, coming to the proteins. So in this rice, major component is starch. Along with this major component starch, it contains proteins and fats in some minute quantities or other relevant quantities. The major component of rice is starch, and in our rice, proteins and fats are also there. But when compared to starch, these are very less. So children, so against rice in the column proteins, we have written present. And next, coming to the fats. So rice also contains some amount of fats also. So that's why here against rice in this fats column we have written present. So first column is finished. So rice, in rice starch is present. The other name of starch is carbohydrate. The major component of rice is starch. So against this one, children, I am writing present. P for present, A for absent. Next, coming to the proteins. Proteins are bodybuilding food materials, and in this rice it contains some proteins value also. So that's why here I am writing present. And against rice in the column of fats also I am writing present, because rice also contains some amount of fats in it. So children, we'll go to the next column. So here, what is the food item that you have given here? Potato. Potato is very very rich in carbohydrate, that means starch. So definitely potato contains starch in it. So that's why here against potato I am writing present. Next, proteins. So along with starch or carbohydrates, this potato contains some amounts of proteins and fats also. That's why potato against in proteins column I am writing present. Next, against potato in fats column, here also I am writing present, because this potato contains starch, proteins and fats. Next, coming to the milk. So milk is a protein food. Milk is a protein food. It is rich in proteins value. So against proteins I am writing present. Why? Because milk is rich in proteins and it also contains some amount of fats. So that's why against this fats column, against milk also, it is present. Now coming to the starch. This milk contains negligible amount of starch. So that's why here we have to write absent only in milk column. Only minute, that means negligible amounts of starch is present, but we are not taking into account. That's why again is the starch column. In milk, I am writing absent. So milk does not contains starch. We can say, children, it is very very important. Keep it in mind. And milk is a protein food. So that's why here in column proteins, I have written present and fats also present. Next, coming to the curd. Curd is also comes from milk, children. So that's why same quantity, because in this one also again is starch. I am writing absent. Why? Because this also does not contains so much amount of starch in it, but only this is in minute quantities that we should not take into account, or we can say it is a negligible. So again is the starch column, again is curd. I am writing absent. Next, again is the proteins. I am writing present, because milk and curd are containing proteins and fats. So again is the curd in proteins column. I am writing present. Next, coming to the fats. So curd, by eating curd our body gets fat content, children. So in this one, this column will be finished. Next, coming to the egg. So in this egg column, in this egg column, here I am writing starch, proteins and fats. So here also I am writing egg. Proteins, egg is rich in protein value. Egg is rich in proteins value. Egg is rich in proteins value. So that's why here we have to write present. And against fats, I am writing present. So here some amount of egg yolk consists of starch in it, but whereas here also we can write egg yolk also contains some amount of starch and is also negligible. So against this egg also I am writing absent, children, because it also does not contain negligible amount of more amount of starch. So that's why against egg also I am writing this absent. So this milk, curd and egg are not having large quantities of starch in it. So children, this is the column. Next, we will go to the next topic, children. Now we will see another table, children. In this one, we contain serial number, food items, food components. Again, food components are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals, children. So here, suppose rice, dal, ghee, vegetable curry, sambar, curd and fruits are eaten by you for today's dinner. Suppose you have eaten all these items in yesterday's lunch. So now we have to know which type of component present in it, and by eating these quantities, which type of component that your body gets. Now we will see. So we will know that again the food components are mainly carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. So by eating rice, which type of food component our body gets? Now we will see. So rice is rich in carbohydrates. The other name of carbohydrates is starch. That's why your body will get, by eating rice, carbohydrates. The other name of this carbohydrate is starch. Next, coming to the dal. Suppose if you have eaten dal with any vegetables or leafy vegetables, then which type of component that your body gets by eating this one? Now we will see. So dal is rich in proteins value. Dal is very very rich in protein value. It contains so much of proteins in it. So that's why our body will get proteins by eating dal along with rice. Next one, next coming to the ghee. Ghee is very rich in fat content. It gives more energy. It gives more energy. By eating this ghee, our body will get fat content. So, ghee contains fats in it. That's why ghee contains fats. That's why our body will get fat content by eating this ghee. But whereas we have to take this ghee in small quantities, because fats are oils and fats are very rich in energetic values. So our body will get only minute quantities. So don't take fat content food in more quantity, children. Next, going to the vegetable curry. Suppose any vegetable curry that you have eaten for your lunch, yesterday's dinner, or something lunch. Then which type of food component that our body will get? So here cheese, see children, vegetables contains definitely different types of vitamins and minerals. Vegetables are very rich in vitamins and minerals. You have to take either vegetables or leafy vegetables, then definitely our body will get vitamins and fibers. But whereas along with this vitamins and minerals, here I have written fibers also. Why? Because some vegetables will contain fibrous materials. That means our body will also get fibers along with vitamins and minerals if you take vegetable curries. Now, what are these fiber containing vegetables? Means peas, lady's finger, like that. Suppose if you eat that type of vegetables in your diet, then your body will get fiber content. Definitely, in order to digest our food properly, definitely you should take fibrous material along with your food items, children. Next, going to the sambar. In sambar, we will prepare sambar by using dal. That's why dal is rich in proteins. So the major component of sambar, in order to prepare sambar, is dal. Dal is rich in protein. So that's why sambar contains proteins value, more proteins. Why? Because it is made with dal. So if you make this sambar along with some vegetables, and then also your body will get along with proteins some amount of vitamins and minerals also your body will get. Next, coming to the curd. Curd is rich in fat value. So by eating curd, our body will get fats. Next, coming to the fruits. So by eating vegetables and fruits, our body will get both vitamins and minerals. Different types of vitamins and minerals will be obtained by eating different types of fruits. But some fruits contains fibrous fruits also there. So by eating that fibrous fruits, then our body will get fibers also. So against fruits, I am writing fibers, vitamins and minerals. So both vegetables and fruits will be rich in vitamins and minerals. These vitamins and minerals will be helpful in our body. Vitamins are helpful in vitamins will protect against our body disease causing germs, children. So you have to eat different types of vegetables along with your lunch. So this is the table that we have learned up to now. Now children, rice is rich in carbohydrates. Dal, by eating dal, our body will get proteins. By eating ghee or by taking ghee, our body gets fats. By taking vegetable curry, fibers, vitamins and minerals. And by taking sambar in your lunch, then our body will get proteins. And by taking curd, our body gets fats. And by taking fruits daily, our body will get fibers, vitamins and minerals, children. Next, we will move to the next topic, balanced diet.